Now let's address the main features of applications for smart devices. First, we will see the different types of applications and the purpose of each one. Then we will continue with the different types of applications regarding their connectivity. Finally, we will see the need for them to be native to each platform. Every smart device application we develop will necessarily have a part running on a web server. Not only in the case of a line of business application, applications that are only a part of the business application, but also in the case of consumer applications. That is to say, applications made to be uploaded to the markets of the different technologies to be downloaded later by any user. Between these two possibilities are applications of the type company to consumer applications, which are applications developed by companies for their customers, and also to extend their user base. Our event day application can be considered a hybrid, since it will have a part whose focus will be on the attendees of the event in question, a front end, and another part that will be used by the organizers of the event to be able to modify data in a mobile way, in other words, the back end. In this way, we will have access to the front end and back end using both a web browser and an intelligent device. An important aspect in the case of the back end has to do with security. Of course, not any user will be authorized to make changes in the application data, which will be centralized on a server. So in order to do this, we will also have to incorporate security modules in the smart device applications that can then restrict authorized users, and even restrict what actions they can execute on the different modules of the application. In this way, through a backend in the mobile devices, authorized users will be able to modify the information of a presentation up to a second before it starts. Just as GeneXus allowed us to develop applications in Java or .NET for web, it'll also allow us to develop applications for Apple devices with iOS operating system in Swift language or for Android devices in Java language. As usual, applications will be multi-platform. With GeneXus, we will be able to generate the same application regardless of the platform we choose. We will only program or design specific characteristics according to the platform on which it will run when necessary. An important scenario for smart devices is to allow the application, or part of it, to keep running when disconnected from the internet. In the case of our application, we will want the user to be able to continue seeing all the conference agenda and all the related information, even when the connection is lost. Then, when it's reestablished, the application will automatically update its local data, synchronizing with the data of the centralized server. This synchronization is carried out sending and receiving information in both ways, and these operations will be known as send and receive. However, some tasks will require access to the web server, either because of their sensitivity, in other words, tasks that need to be validated in the centralized database, or due to the speed at which the data changes. All these tasks must be executed online. In our case, user login and video display of a session are tasks that are carried out online, so that we can choose which objects of the application will run offline and which not. As for offline applications, we will return to them at the end of this course. The important thing to keep in mind is that online applications will not have a local database, and they'll always be connected to the web server to get the information. Regarding the characteristics of smart device applications, we know that the user experience is fundamental. Each platform has different guidelines regarding the look and feel of the application. In other words, how the application should look like, how the actions should be seen, and other aspects that we will see later. But, in addition, we're also going to want them to be integrated with the native functionalities of the device, both software and hardware. For example, to integrate them with the device's camera, with the program to make telephone calls, with GPS, and so on. Users will demand that their experience using the applications we develop is consistent with the rest of the applications that they use in their device. For all these reasons, applications for intelligent devices must be native applications. For example, in the case of an iPhone, on the left, there's a screen of contacts for a native chat application in the device, which has an action bar at the top, to show the actions that can be done on the screen, and also has a search option. To the right is the application we developed using GeneXus for the event, and we can see that they look very similar. We also see that at the top is the name of the screen we're viewing. In the search bar, the center of the screen is where the information is shown. In one case, the list of contacts. In the other, the list of speakers. And if we change to another technology, for example, on the left, we see the results screen of a search in the Event Day application on an iPhone. And on the right, we have the same application, but for an Android phone. We see that they have differences. For example, in the case of the iPhone, the main menu is always visible, whereas in Android, it'll be shown or not according to the screen. Because when we access an option called from the main menu, the menu disappears. Also, in an iPhone, the back option is inside the application itself. In an Android, we have a button of the phone in addition to the option incorporated into the application. Here's another example. On the iPhone, to the right, we can see the detail screen of a presentation. And when we select the share option, it displays a dialog of the iOS operating system that shows the applications compatible with the format of the content that we want to share. For example, if we share the information in a text message, the native iOS application is opened to send messages. In the case of Android, on the left, we see the same screen, but clicking on the share option opens a different dialog. It's also a dialog of the Android operating system. And if we use the share messages option, the default native application of the operating system will open. So, we've seen that GeneXus makes it possible to develop applications for different purposes, and that we can even have fully or partially online or offline applications. Also, we've described the need for the developed applications to be native and behave in a specific way according to the operating system and the hardware of each device, in order to take full advantage of the potential this offers us. With GeneXus, we will be able to develop applications that look similar in different devices, and at the same time, take advantage of the particularities of each platform. As usual, all this will be done most of the times automatically and transparently for the developer.